Hey, what's going on, guys? It's TECHOSAUR here. In a previous video, I showed you how to manually adjust the GPU clock speed for an up to 2600 MHz, which is all thanks to raising the TDP from default 30W to 45W. And we have seen some performance difference with CPU boost on versus off. However, in that video, I only showed you one game benchmark, and I received some feedback saying that it was only half the picture and more benchmarks are needed to learn more about the possible gains. So in this video, I'll try to cover more by doing benchmarks in 11 other titles besides Cyberpunk 2077, in hope to make it as clear as possible this time. But in case you haven't watched the previous videos about this, I recommend you to do so if you would like to learn how to set it up, as it's more dedicated for guiding you through the process. Instead, in this video, we'll mainly focus at game performance benchmark. But briefly, what I'm essentially about to do is going to smokeless tool and adjusting some power limit for an up to 45W, and then head back to the Windows and setting them in the same way to 45W by using the Ryzen Universal tool in order to match the TDP limit in both BIOS and OS. But of course, higher TDP requires better cooling. I usually set the fans to maximum speed, and it would help greatly if you have a third party back cover allowing better airflow to the APU, such as the one from GS Aux or handheld DIY mode cases. In the coming benchmark, I'll be using the GS Aux Benz version, which I already covered in a previous video that you can check out here. These settings should work the same way across both the ROG Ally and the Legion Go, since they share the same APU specifications. And also previously we have seen that the Legion Go is capable enough to be set at 45W TDP. But for the sake of time saving, I'll be doing benchmarks on the Ally. Anyway, 45W will be our max TDP, and we'll try with CPU boost on and off as well, in order to see how performance varies when the CPU is limited to its 3.3 GHz base clock. So if you wonder why in the coming benchmarks, I'll be fixing the GPU clock at 2500 MHz with CPU boost on, it's because if we go beyond that, the GPU would start to draw more power, taking it away from the CPU, and thus causing lower CPU clock, and eventually performance will degrade significantly. But if we turn off the CPU boost, we can raise the GPU clock to 2600 MHz. Also, if we go to 2700 MHz with CPU boost off, we'll experience the same performance worsening. So in order to get peak performance with CPU boost on, our maximum GPU clock will be 2500 MHz. Instead, with CPU boost off, it will be at 2600 MHz, and we'll compare which is the best config. Starting alphabetically with Borderlands 3, here at default 30W TDP, we got a 60 average FPS with boost off, and with CPU boost on, it's 58, so that will be our baseline. Now setting TDP to 45W with CPU boost on, and setting GPU clock manually to 2500 MHz, we got 64 FPS, which is about 4 more than the default setup, and with CPU boost off, it's about the same, with also improvement in low FPS. As you can see, they are performing consistently well. Switching to the second game we have, which is Forza Motorsport. Here our best performing setups are all three of 2500 MHz with boost on and off, as well as GPU clock of 2600 MHz with CPU boost off. All three are performing pretty similar, gaining about 2 to 3 FPS than the default setup. But as you can see in this title, even at default 30W, if we turn off CPU boost, you will have increased performance, because you will have a higher power allocated for GPU, so that makes Forza Motorsport a purely GPU bounded title. And for that, with 2600 MHz with boost off being at the top of chart. Finally, a point to clear here, if we fix the GPU clock to 2500 at 30W TDP, whether it's with boost on or off, it's going to lag quite behind. Now our third game is Helldivers 2. While this one doesn't have an integrated benchmark tool, I tried to mimic the same scene, being as close as possible to the same environment and the resources consumption. So here we got the best score again with GPU clock at 2600 MHz and CPU boost off. And as you can see, the huge improvement we got for the 0.2 low percentile. As for average, it's pretty similar to 2500 MHz with CPU boost on. We are again seeing the same trend from before, with this TW giving us a minimal average FPS increase, but better performance consistency. Now let's head on to Horizon Zero Dawn. Here we see again when we fix the GPU clock at 2600 with CPU boost off, we are getting the best result. But also the two setups with 2500 MHz are pretty close, offering improvement in low 0.2 percentile FPS. Now we're heading to another fresh title, which is Manor Lords. And here we see a significant average FPS increase with GPU clock at 2600 MHz with CPU boost off, giving us an average of solid 90 FPS. That's about 8 FPS more than the default 30 watt with CPU boost off. We also have in second place 2500 MHz with CPU boost on. Now just for reference, as you can see again, if we keep TDP at 30 watt and manually fix the GPU clock to 2500 MHz, it's limiting our power and thus causing so much performance worsening. So my advice is to never tweak the GPU clock even with CPU boost off if you are limited by 30 watt TDP. Now let's move on to Metro Exodus. Here we see pretty close result, but still the tweak setups are giving us as low as 1 average FPS gain. The next game we have is Mortal Kombat 1. Our base setup here is GPU clock at 2500 MHz with CPU boost on, giving us an average of 55 FPS. Now if we compare it to the default one, we got a 3 FPS increase on average. Instead with GPU clock at 2600 MHz with CPU boost off, we got 53 average. So we can conclude that this title is definitely relying more on CPU, benefiting a bit from CPU boosting clock. And now on to heading to yet another fun game, which is No Rest for the Week. Here we see the setup with 2600 MHz with CPU boost off is giving us a standard 30 FPS experience, while the default one is giving us 28 FPS. So thanks to this tweak, we can start to average at 30 FPS on this awesome title. Also, with 2500 MHz with boost on, we could also achieve a 30 FPS on average. And moving on to an all-time popular title, Red Dead Redemption 2, in this specific one, we see quite similar scores with barely any gains. As well as in Resident Evil 4, there is some improvement in average, but really not worth noting. Now we have arrived at the 11th one, which is Street Fighter 6 benchmark tool. In this one, our best performance setup is when we have GPU clock at 2500 MHz with CPU boost on. And in the second place, surprisingly, it's the default 30 watt with CPU boost on. So just like Mortal Kombat 1, Street Fighter 6 is also more CPU bounded, which benefits more from CPU boosting the clock. And as you can see, the loss in average FPS we got is about 2 to 3 when we have CPU boost off. So finally, if we add the result we got on the last video with Cyberpunk 2077, where we got about 3 average FPS improvement, we can conclude that increasing TDP above default 30 watt can give us small gains, provided that we set GPU clock to 2500 with CPU boost on and 2600 with CPU boost off, in order to avoid any power limitations. And of course, we have seen that changing the GPU clock to 2500 MHz while capping power limit to 30 watt will worsen performance significantly, so it's totally unadvisable. Something I need to clarify is that if you have CPU boost off and set the GPU clock to 2500 MHz, it won't consume 45 watt. Instead, it will hover around 35 to 40 watt. It would reach 45 watt only when you put GPU clock to 2600 MHz. So there you go. I hope this comparison was evident enough to showcase the performance gains possible with this tweak. I wouldn't emphasize it's a vital performance gain, but if you were missing some FPS to feel a smoother gameplay, provided you keep temps well controlled, then this tweak may safely give you some free performance. And if we add up the memory timing tweak as well, we may eventually start to see some notable performance improvement. So definitely check those ones out as well. And if you have any question, feel free to leave it in the comment section or connect over at TECHOSAUR Discord server. And alright, that's it for this video. I hope it was useful. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like and subscribe to TECHOSAUR for keeping up to date with future videos. Thanks for watching and support, and see you in the next one.